down here in the lobby, and I think to the left.
Do you have a pile of announcements, pending announcements that we do later?
Yeah.
Vicky wants to remind everybody to know that the New York, that the Northeast Caucus.
Yeah, right, I know.
Mark? Well, Joe, nobody's complained it isn't working yet.
Take a minute. Stay right where you are.
Timothy Hall of the California delegation. Timothy Hall, is he in present, please? Step over.
Steve Nelson, delegate from Illinois. First of all, what are your thoughts on this convention? How's it going?
It's going reasonably well. This is the third presidential nominating convention that I've attended, and it's running along pretty smoothly by our standards, at least.
For our viewers watching at home, how would you describe what's going on inside this room right now?
Pardon me?
For our viewers at home watching, how would you describe what's going on inside this room right now?
Okay, we have at this moment the state chairmen are counting their individual delegates. The largest delegation is from California, which is 75 people, and they're rather tightly packed, so you can imagine how difficult it is to tabulate with five candidates, none of the above, among 75 people. Each of the state chairmen are going through this process. As they finish with this process, they proceed to the computer and enter the state results on the computer file. Then they will go and present these to the, I believe, the secretary of the party or secretary of the convention. And we will then have the traditional roll call of the states, only in our case it's done in alphabetical order, precisely to avoid the vote swapping and general shenanigans that occur with the other parties at this time.
You said this is your third convention. How would you compare this kind of discussion and debate that's been going on the past couple of days to past conventions?
This is fairly standard practice among libertarians. We have long since been noted that our bookstalls come from very high octane intellectual wells, that particularly when you compare them with the comic book literacy, and I quote a commentator, the comic book literacy of the big parties. And generally speaking, this is very much par for the course for a libertarian convention. We do indeed, we note the somewhat tedious adherence to Robert's rules. That is simply because Robert's rules are the fastest, entirely fair way of determining a question.
Steve Nelson, we'll let you get back to your voting of the Illinois delegation. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I asked them just for assistance in helping pay for the airfare. And it happened. And the first time I asked, I got three. The second time I asked, I got two. And the third time,
see,
I got one.
They shoot their
and I could
they
ask.
Them. They shoot. They kept talking. They test out this voting.
There are four. Well, actually, there are.
All these delegations that have.
There's one this weekend. There's one in December. One, so this doesn't count because you're already here. There's one in December, there's one in April, there's one in August, one in December, one in April, and then the next week.
Okay, conference audio tapes are available for sale outside the Grand Ballroom.
Thank you.
folks supporting Dick Body had contributed less than $10 to last year's national. People who are supporting
Texas
given better than $100. Does that give you an idea of the level of commitment to the program? And the kind of people who are
some good publicity with it.
What was the score in New York?
I was actually expecting a beat.
15-9. That's not bad.
No, I know. That's vice presidential candidates. And then again, I also from the type of growth that the New York Party has done to their population. I would expect
that. I was going to just rattle them off before.
I don't want to control that.
I don't want to write it down because I'm going to
pass it up.
Right now, they're panning around. They're walking around.
When I make these announcements, I just have to, or they just...
No, you don't have to. Well, it depends. The editor,
so they'll
the
be
director
ready when I call it back to school.
I'd like you to give me a warning on that so I can make sure they are.
Which is even more scary.
It's too late now.
It's too late.
Much too late.
Once they get to a certain point, everything's frozen.
The numbers are frozen. Nothing we can do. Joe, you ready? Only read the ones that
I've. Will any Dick Body supporters who have singing skills please meet over by the Body for President sign on the left side of the floor? Any Body supporters who have singing skills, please meet over by the Body for President sign.
Thea McLean of the California delegation and Stephen Clark of the Arizona delegation, what's going on in your delegations at the moment?
Well, ours has already cast their ballots. We only had 10, and we've already cast and entered them, 7 for Maru and 3 for Body. So we're done and waiting anxiously to hear what the other states have done.
Do you think that's indicative of how the convention would go?
I think it's going to be a lot closer. If we get a first ballot, I'll be very close to getting the required because of the fact that none of the above has a very greater sentiment than the other past conventions.
Thea McLean of the California delegation, have your folks voted yet?
Yes, we have, and I believe so far it's about 34 for Body to 32, plus none of the above. Body is of Californian, but then there's a lot of people that are out there for Maru, too.
Is this your first convention?
No, this is my fourth nominating convention, and I've gone to one off year in 85.
What's it like for you?
It's exciting. I've seen a lot of changes over the last 11 years. Since the 79.
And how about you, Thea?
I was at the 87 convention in Seattle. So this is my second nominating convention.
We'll let you get back to your delegations. Thanks for spending some time with us.
We're done. Louisiana. Missouri,
Nebraska,
New Hampshire, New Mexico, Rhode Island, South Carolina. Everyone else, your vote has been recorded.
Mr. Secretary.
Right from the
he's from Ohio. They want to verify.
Well.
Oh, he's from Ohio.
Three Body, 9 Maru.
Mr. Secretary, proud to announce that California has cast their votes.
Hold on, we're checking right now.
Yeah.
Yep, you're all set. Okay, Arkansas.
We are still awaiting votes from the following: Arkansas,
Illinois, Missouri, Nebraska, New Mexico, Rhode Island, and South Carolina. All other delegations' votes have been recorded.
You gotta wait till later. What did you guys eat for lunch? What did you guys have for lunch? Did you?
Andrew Ensley of the Ohio delegation, you're also one of the youngest delegates here at the convention. What's it like for you?
It's very exciting. I've wanted to be here for a long time. I finally made it to a presidential convention. For me, the Libertarian Party is the only party that is currently going to be on the ticket, hopefully in all 50 states and in D.C., that will represent the American values to be left alone from government to regulate the pursuits of our own lives in our own way, as long as we do not violate the rights of anyone else. And it is to that end that we believe the Libertarian Party will bring back liberty to the United States in the 21st century and hopefully in 92.
Why did you personally get involved at such a young age?
I am able to say that I've been a libertarian my entire life because my parents discovered it just before I was born. For me, it's been a very almost religious experience to be part of such a large and growing group of people that are concerned about the American people, and that we can, if we get to the Congress and to the presidency, can bring back what the Democrats and Republicans have stolen from the American dream.
Andrew Ensley of the Ohio delegation, thank you.
Thank you very much. Glad to have you here. Thanks.
What's the answer?
I want to see any California regional chair that has not picked up their national prospect.
All right.
They can't hear me.
Or when we're done, Jim. The announcement at the end of the day.
Well, I figured I'd do it while we had time and everyone was
Arkansas,
still here.
Arkansas? Rhode Island's in. Just Arkansas. Paul Jacobs seems to be back in the camera.
Where are we? Let's just... Okay, one more. Let's try it again. Oh, we got try it all over again, Frank.
Okay.
Somewhere we got too many characters in there. Great.
Hey, okay.
There we go.
Yeah,
three votes.
Two. There. Then I just go down.
Cursor down.
One.
And if that's it, then just press E.
E or enter?
Letter E.
Okay.
And that's it.
Anybody else for entering a vote?
Hi.
Scroll page advance to see
exit F3 to exit and F2 to close.
Exit F2 to see that whether Arkansas is right.
I saw Paul Jacob up there. Arkansas's done.
It's voted.
It's on. Close F3 to get out.
I just want to make sure they're all there, right?
Okay.
Okay, print it for me. Print it.
Dick and Ann Motti, how's it going for you?
Good. A little hectic, a little busy, a lot of fun.
Is there a lot of last-minute negotiating going on at the moment?
I'm not aware of it, if there is, but I suspect so.
I should point out this is your wife.
Yes.
Yes. A nervous wife, I might add. This is my first experience with anything like this, and it's exciting, but it's frightening.
Thank you.
We will then go in alphabetical order. To save time, will the delegation chair, who's announcing the vote, line up at the microphone so that we don't lose a lot of time.
You ready to record? We don't have to record.
Okay, the first state is Michigan. Please record your vote.
Michigan, whose senior senator Don Riegel was a major player in the SNL ripoff. We look forward to putting a libertarian in the White House and Mr. Riegel in jail. Michigan casts 10 votes for Andre Moreau. 4 votes for David Raflov. 3 votes for Dick Boddy, and 0 for the other two.
Did you get that? Keep going. Minnesota.
Minnesota, the home of Hubert Humphrey. Cast 8 votes for Maru, 1 vote for Boddy, 1 vote for Ravlo.
Okay. Mississippi. No delegates from Mississippi. Missouri. None from Missouri.
Missouri, the show me state, says that Andre Maru has shown us that he will work for ballot access in Missouri. We just lost a heartbreaking ballot access battle, and we have to get a whole lot of petitions signed. Missouri cast 5 votes for Maru and 2 for Boddy. We will support whoever wins.
Montana. Nebraska.
Nebraska casts its 2 votes for Dick Boddy.
Nevada.
The state of Nevada, battle-born and freedom-loving, we cast 5 votes for Dick Boddy, 2 votes for Andre Maru.
New Hampshire.
On behalf of the New Hampshire delegation, I turn over the microphone to Libertarian Party State Representative Calvin Warburton.
New Hampshire, the state without an income tax or a sales tax. Yeah! The state where the first vote for presidential primary takes place. Cast 5 votes for Maru and 3 for Boddy.
New Jersey.
New Jersey, the first state to ratify the Bill of Rights, cast 5 votes for Richard Boddy and 6 votes for Andre Maru.
New Mexico.
Mr. Chairman, New Mexico, the state of enchantment, cast 1 vote for Dick Boddy and 5 votes for Andre Maru.
New York.
As liberty is truly enlightening the world abroad, New York, the home of our libertarian symbol, the statue that has always borne the title, Liberty Enlightening the World. Is also the home of huddled masses yearning to breathe free. As the Empire State is declining and falling, our emperor brags that he has opened more prisons than any emperor in New York's history. He and his minions have given us the highest taxes in the entire country, the worst schools per dollar in the country, and not coincidentally, the highest paid legislators in the entire country. New York casts 9 votes for Dick Boddy, 15 votes for Andre Maru, and 1 vote for none of the above.
North Carolina.
North-
North Carolina, the first state to declare for freedom, but we wonder where it went. Cast one vote for Biden and six votes for Andre Moreau.
Ohio.
Ohio, the 17th state of the Union, the 17th star in our flag, not George Bush's, not the CFR's, not the Trilateral Commission's, or any other one-worlder enemy of liberty, casts nine votes for the man who should be the next president of the United States, Andre Moreau, three votes for Dick Boddy, who's almost as good, and two votes for none of the above.
Oklahoma.
The great state of Oklahoma proudly cast one vote for Dick Boddy, two votes for Andre Moreau.
Oregon.
Oregon, home of the late Senator Wayne Morse, the only one with the courage to vote against the Gulf of Tonkin resolution. Home of Senator Mark Hatfield, the only Republican to vote against George Bush's slaughter in Iraq. And home of Toni Nathan, the first woman to get an Electoral College vote 12 years before Geraldine Ferraro. Proudly cast eight votes for Dick Boddy and four votes for Andre Moreau.
Number one, Penn State.
Save the
editorials. Mr. Chair, the Pennsylvania delegation would like to note that two of our original delegates did not make it to the convention due to a rather happy event. The Pennsylvania delegation would like to congratulate John and Linda Morrison on the birth of Ian Johansson Morrison, born on the opening day of this convention. The state of Pennsylvania, the Keystone State, the birthplace of the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution, Pennsylvania, the keystone of the Libertarian Party, hereby casts five votes for favorite son, Hans Schroeder, zero votes for David Roflob, two votes for none of the above, three votes for Dick Boddy, and 11 votes for Andre Moreau.
Rhode Island.
Rhode Island casts its one vote for Andre Moreau.
South Carolina.
The Palmetto State of South Carolina, home of the political scandal Operation Lost Trust, proudly casts five votes for Andre Moreau and one vote for none of the above.
Tennessee,
the volunteer state, wishes the United States was the volunteer nation. Tennessee casts two votes for Boddy and one vote for Moreau.
Texas.
The Republic of Texas. Where such American heroes as Stephen F. Austin, Jim Bowie, William Travis, Sam Houston, and other great Americans and libertarians made history and became immortalized, cast one abstention, nine votes for Dick Boddy, 22 votes for the next president of the United States, Andre Moreau. Thank you.
Utah.
Mr. Chairman, the pretty great state of Utah
Well, it's okay if you like that sort of place, I guess. The Beehive State, symbol of collectivism. The territory... The territory of Deseret, home of Republicans for higher taxes and bigger government, home of Democrats for censorship and drug testing, one of America's tax hells, according to the National Taxpayers Union, the state with the nation's lowest per capita consumption of alcohol and tobacco, and the highest per capita consumption of ice cream and Jell-O. The galactic headquarters of the Aquarian Libertarian Conspiracy, publisher of the Cosmic Wink, temporarily out of service, and host of the 1993 Libertarian Convention with our tentative theme of, and now for something completely different, or, excuse us, but we're trying to have a party. Cast one vote for Dick Body and two votes for Andre Maru.
Virginia.
Mr. Chairman, the Commonwealth of Virginia, birthplace of Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, and George Mason, Virginia, the cradle of the Bill of Rights, whose government is the violator of every clause in that Bill of Rights. The Commonwealth of Virginia cast six votes for Dick Body and eight votes for Andre Maru.
State of Washington.
The delegates of the state of Washington, the other Washington, the good Washington, where we all wish we'd been named Jefferson, cast its votes as follows. For Dick Body, 9 votes. Andre Maru, 5 votes. None of the above, 2 votes.
Wisconsin. The state of Wisconsin, the birthplace of school choice in one of 27 states. In one of 27 states to have ballot access, ballot status, is proud to cast all 8 votes for the next president of the United States, Andre Maru.
The state of Alabama, where we have every conceivable tax and where our new Republican governor, the first since the War of Northern Aggression, just outdid all previous Democrats in raising taxes on the people of Alabama, and where we have one of the most oppressive ballot access laws in the country, but we will be on the ballot in 92. Cast for Dick Body, 1 vote, and Andre Maru, 3 votes.
Arizona.
From the state of Arizona, the bankruptcy capital of the country, which will produce the next Libertarian mayor this November, the desperate state of Arizona casts 3 votes for Dick Body and 7 votes for Andre Maru.
Arkansas,
where we know that Alaska comes first, the great people of Arkansas have never given this country a president. We do not want to begin with Bill Clinton. They have sent a delegation to give us an alternative, and therefore we cast two votes for Dick Boddy and one vote for Andre Maru.
Alaska, the state privileged to have elected Libertarian Andre Maru to its state legislature, cast all six votes for our candidate and yours, Andre Maru.
California.
Hush draws over the crowd.
The omnipotent cult of California. Home of 50,000 registered voters, three presidential candidates, John Hospers, David Berglund, and Ed Clark. Home of Proposition 13 and a record number of dues-paying members. And so many libertarians elected to office, we're starting to lose count. Casts our 75 votes the following ways. For our favorite son, Dick Boddy, 33 votes. For Andre Maru, 32 votes. One vote for Schroeder, 0 votes for Raflob, 8 votes for none of the above, and 1 abstention.
Colorado.
The great centennial state of Colorado, the highest state in America, cast 7 votes for Dick Boddy and 6 votes for Andre Maru.
Connecticut.
Connecticut, the home of Lowell Weicker and numerous other socialist parasites. Which only last week became the 41st state in this union to burden its residents with an income tax. Casts 3 votes for Andre Maru and 2 votes for Dick Boddy.
Okay, there's a question on the Colorado vote totals. Would the delegation chair go to a microphone? Repeat the votes.
We had 7 votes for Dick Boddy, 6 votes for Andre Maru.
Thank you. Delaware. Did we have a vote?
Delaware is very pleased to cast its 1 vote for Dick Boddy.
District of Columbia.
The District of Columbia has 1 abstention and casts 1 vote for Richard Boddy.
Florida.
Florida, the Sunshine State, where other than presidential candidates, no third party candidate has ever been on the ballot, casts 6 votes for Dick Boddy, 13 for Andre Maru.
Georgia.
The great statist state of Georgia, where William Tecumseh Sherman marched the Blue Army to the sea in a scorched earth policy, and we can really tell you about federal intervention in your life. Proudly cast 1 vote for Andre Maru, 3 votes for Dick Boddy.
Hawaii,
the 50th state, the state with the least tradition of personal liberty, the nation's number one tax in business hell, cast its 4 votes for Richard Benjamin Boddy.
Illinois.
Mr. Chairman, the libertarians of the great state of Illinois, the host of this convention, Liberty Triumphant. The convention that, through several marvelous bits of world history, ended up being named after the brave people of Berlin, Prague, Warsaw, Bucharest, Leningrad, St. Petersburg, and Moscow. And the site of Chicago, the home of three products of private enterprise, the world's tallest building, the world's deepest pizza, and the world's largest cemetery vote. We of Illinois sincerely welcome the LP delegates and guests with all our hearts, and we are proud to cast the following votes. None of the above, 2 votes. Mr. Raflob, 1 vote. Mr. Schroeder, 1 vote. Mr. Boddy, 8 votes. Mr. Maru, 10 votes.
Indiana, the great Hoosier state, regrettably the home of our current vice president, and hopefully on the ballot to elect the next libertarian president, casts 7 votes for Andre Maru and 1 for Dick Boddy.
Iowa, which regrettably has the highest relative increase of government spending and bureaucrats per capita in the nation, casts 1 vote for Andre Maru and 1 vote for Dick Boddy.
Kansas, unfortunately the home of Robert Dole, tax collector for the warfare welfare state. Nonetheless, the people of Kansas, the heartland of America, come with pride, pleasure, and hope for the future to cast 7 votes for Andre Maru, 1 vote for Dick Boddy.
Kentucky.
Mr. Chair, the Commonwealth of Kentucky, where you cannot sign a Libertarian Party ballot access petition unless you are registered as a Libertarian voter, casts its 3 delegate votes for Mr. Andre Maru.
Louisiana, we say to those who complain about government, register and vote, it's later than you think. Gives all 4 votes to future President of the United States, Andre Maru.
Maine,
we still haven't seceded from the Union yet. We're still here. Maine, the home of Andrew Adam, who gave his ballot status in 1992, cast 1 vote for none of the above, 1 vote for Andre Maru, 2 votes for Dick Boddy.
Maryland.
The free state of Maryland, home of the Piscataway Indians, the legitimate owners of Washington, D.C., proudly casts and proudly and very individualistically casts its votes as follows. 2 votes for Mary Ruart, 1 vote for Craig Franklin, 1 vote for Nancy Lord, 2 votes for Dick Boddy, and 5 votes for Andre Maru.
And last but certainly not least, Taxachusetts.
The delegation from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, where the revolution for American independence and individual liberty began. Birthplace of Samuel Adams. And current home of Ted Kennedy. Casts 1 vote for none of the above, 3 votes for Dick Boddy, and 7 votes for the next president of the United States, Andre Maru.
Would Maryland please repeat their total? Maryland?
Just the writings.
The write-ins were 2 votes for Mary Ruart, 1 vote for Craig Franklin, and 1 vote for Dr. Nancy Lord.
Okay, we have some results. The results of the first ballot. It takes 225 votes to elect.
Not everybody votes.
The totals are as follows. Franklin, 1 vote. Ruart, 2 votes. Lord, 1 vote. Rothlob, 6 votes. Schroeder, 7 votes. Noda, 20 votes. Body, 155. And Andre Maru, 257 votes. Our next candidate, Andre Maru. Come to order, please. Order, please. Order. Order so we can hear from the candidate.
Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. The reason you heard that, as you may know, I was born and raised in Texas. My mother is here. My father is buried in Texas. I have a number of relatives in Texas. It's great to be up here. Somebody once said that happiness is not pleasure, happiness is victory. And but as Mary Ruart said earlier today, we are all winners here. There are no losers here. We do need to coalesce for victory. We do need to come together and fight the statists. It's been a long, hard road. I've campaigned in a lot of places. This is my fifth campaign, the second nationally. As you know, I campaigned in all 50 states in 1988, only the second person to do that. I'm looking forward to the next 14 months or so. I think we're going to do a lot better than anybody thinks we're going to do, as you are. As you know, the centerpiece of my campaign will be as follows: to repeal the income tax and abolish the IRS. It is important that the party that is pro-choice in almost everything have a choice in politics, too. I want to extend my congratulations to my esteemed opponent or opponents. They did a good job. They did a good job, but as you know, in politics, as in football, there is a winner. I played 6 years of football, and believe me, I know that because I lost too. This is my fifth campaign, as I've already mentioned. I am looking forward to the next 14 months. Churchill promised England only blood, sweat, and tears. I'm not going to be quite that draconian, but believe me, I need your help. This is going to be a long, hard-fought campaign. We're going to be doing wonders in New Hampshire. I will predict. I will predict again that we're going to do far better than anybody thinks we're going to do. I look forward to it. I like a good fight. I like winning. Please help me. Let's come together for victory. Let's just do it.
I'd like to congratulate Andre Moreau. I'd like to congratulate all of you who participated in this historic effort for our group, our party, our belief, and our efforts. I sincerely want to thank all of those folks that put their effort, time, and helped us in all of the efforts in this campaign. And I want to say, when I said to you before, in the 30 states I went, that Andre Marou is my friend, I still say that at this moment. Thank you all. Thank you, Andre. Let's do it!